Hello everyone, this is Rand here. We are looking at an international pro spreader here. And I thought I'd show you guys how to fix the camera problems that pop up in some mods sometimes. So we have a 2012 International Pro Star spreader. And this particular mod has one of those backwards or reversed cameras, whatever you want to call them, which really annoys me. For those of you that have seen this, I think you probably agree with me. You know, get in here, go to the inside camera. Now I'm going to move my mouse to the right, and you notice I look left. Now if I move my mouse to the left, you notice I look right. So it's actually doing the opposite or reversed of what I'm actually doing with my mouse. And this just drives me nuts. I mean, it's really, really messed up and annoying. I'm not entirely sure why a mod author would release it like this, but yeah. I'm just taking this particular mod. It's one I've got recently, and I want to fix it so I can use it. I know a couple other ones that I have. Let's see if we go under mowers. This John Deere R450 windrower has the same problem. Let's see what's here. Anything else? I know Ellis Chalmers tractor has it. I think this is under miscellaneous. Oh, maybe I don't have it in the game. There's an Ellis Chalmers tractor that has it as well. Has the reversed cameras. So anyway, we got a reverse camera here. I will be back in a moment, and we're going to be out of the game, and I'm going to open it up in Giant's editor, and we'll take a look at how to fix this. Okay, folks, and we're back on my desktop here. I've got the International Pro Spreader mod. It's in its zip file, obviously. So first thing we need to do is unzip it. And for that, I'm just using WinRAR. So we're going to extract to the International Pro Star. It's basically just going to put it in a folder. Grab that, open that up. And we're looking for the i3D file here. Now, we'll have to make sure you have the Giant's editor installed for this. So I already have it installed. We're going to open that up. Close that. You can see the mod here. Oop, zooming in a little too much there. Yep, there it is, the spreader. You can see the camera inside of there. So what we're going to want to do, we can view the indoor camera. So now we're actually looking at the indoor camera. This is what, you know, it's showing in the game. I'm going to plus this out. We're going to find the indoor camera. Now this one's fairly easy. It's pretty close to the top. You know, sometimes you're going to have to scroll down a ways to find it. So yeah, there's the indoor camera. Now over on the right side here, there's two sets of X, Y, and Z values. There's a translate and there's a rotate. There's also scale. I'm not sure I've ever really seen them used. At least not with a camera anyway. Probably some of this other stuff. Yeah, okay, some of this other stuff you can use it with. I'm not all up on what you can all do with this program. I know enough to be trouble, basically. Anyway, I do know the translate, that sets your position, so your XY position in the world. And then your rotate actually sets the rotation. And this is what we're looking for here. We're looking for these three. The rotate X, rotate Y, and rotate Z. So, correct values for this. Rotate X needs to be 0. Rotate Y, and you'll notice it's changing, needs to be negative 180. And your rotate Z, notice I think we're upside down, I think that's the way we are, needs to be 0. And you notice we're back to the right side up, looks like it's looking right. You'll know it's right if it looks right. So, you know, you can see it looks like we're looking out. Same view we had before. I'm guessing the angle must be off by a little bit because, you know, there was some different numbers in there. So we might not have exactly the same view. But it's really close and, you know, to me it looks like where it needs to be. So let me just go over that one more time. Rotate X needs to be 0. Rotate Y needs to be negative 180. And rotate Z needs to be 0. I'm not aware this needs to vary in any way, shape, or form from what I've been told. this is what it should always be. So, for indoor camera anyway. I'm not sure about the outside camera. Yeah, in this case, the outside one has some different values in it. Now we got that set. We're going to hit the save button up here. I'm going to close out of it. And then we're going to zip this back up, so select everything, send to compressed zip folder. Now when you do this, you want to make sure you zip this stuff. Don't go back and, you know, zip this up. You want to make sure you zip what's inside this folder. So now we got one named textures here. And I'm just going to grab the name of this. Name it back to the right one here. Make sure you name it back, you know, what it was originally. So it was International Pro Star Spreader. So it's now International Pro Star Spreader again. Basically, I'm going to just drop this back into my mod folder and meet up guys back in the game. And you can hopefully, well, you can't really see because you can't see my mouse moving. But trust me when I say it should be right. Okay, folks, and we're back in the game here with our International Pro Star Spreader. As you can see from the outside, it doesn't look like anything's changed. Let's hop in it here. And we switch to the internal camera. And if I move my mouse to the right, you notice I look to the right. And if I look to the left, I look to the left. So now our mouse is, our mouse and view is in the correct orientation. It's not being reversed. Which, it just absolutely drives me nuts. It's like, oh boy, how in the world am I supposed to work with this? So yeah, anyway, that's how you fix a reversed camera in Farming Sim 2013 mods. Folks, have any comments or questions about this, let me know. Like I said, the XYZ values are the important ones. My experience, sometimes it does give a little bit weird results from the indoor camera. Sometimes you'll end up like looking like this. Slightly annoying, but it does, you know, end up working right. I'm not sure, maybe you can tweak around with that a little bit. I have no idea. What I've always done, though, is set it to 0, negative 180, and 0, and I'm okay. So, like I said, if you folks have any questions about this, let me know. And hope you enjoyed this little how-to on how to fix camera problems in Farming Sim 2013 mods.